Good morning. Lesson 4.7. This lesson is about writing. Writing equations in a slope point form. Last time we learned how to write equations in a slope intercepted form. Today is a slope and point form. So for this lesson, you are only giving one point. And this is one point, which is x, y. And you are also giving the slope, which is equal to m. Let's see an example. Let's say you are giving a point -6 and 1, and you are giving a slope of 2/3. And you are asked to write the equation for this. Okay, the equations for when you only have one point and a slope is the following. Y minus y1 is equal to the slope times x minus x1. And the y1 and the x1 are the points that you do know. So in our example, here you will write y minus y is 1 is equal to the slope 2/3 times x minus x1 is the point minus minus 6. Let's put it this way. And now let me solve for that parenthesis. Y minus 1 equals 2/3 times x plus 6. If I multiply this, y minus 1 is equal 2/3 x plus 2 times 6 is 12 divided by 3 is 4. There you have it. An equation in a slope point form. Remember that the equation for the slope intercepted form is y equals mx plus b. Today we're writing the point slope. And this is the slope intercepted form. If you are given 2 points, let's say you are given point 2 and 4, and you are also given point 5 and -2, and you are asked to write the equation in the slope point form, you do need the slope. But if you had 2 points, you can find the slope by using the formula that m is equal y1 minus y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So here, let's find the slope. Felipe equals y2, let's say it's 4 minus minus 2 divided by 2 minus 5. And this is equal to 4 plus 2 divided by minus 3. And 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 divided by minus 3. And this is equal to minus 2. So the slope for these 2 points is equal to minus 2. And once you have the slope, now use any point and write the equation in a point slope form. So you write y minus, let me write the first point, minus 4. Equals the slope, which is minus 2, times x minus x1, minus 2. You make this operation, minus 2x plus 4. And there you have the equation in a point slope form. If you had 2 parallel lines, remember that these points are lines, right, in the plane. If you had 2 parallel lines, then the slope of the line 1 is equal to the slope of the line 2. Because the parallel lines never touch. They have the same inclination, the same slope. This slope and these slopes are the same. They are equal. So if you have only the slope for one line and not for the other, you can use the slope for the known line and work that way. Okay, let's do a real life application now. Let's say that you are parasailing and you are dropping and you stop parasailing and now you are being pulled down by a rope. You are parasailing and you ended in the ocean. So there is a boat waiting for you and they are pulling you down. At the rate of 10 feet per second. Every second they pull you down 10 feet down. And after 2 seconds, then you are 25 feet above the boat. About the boat. Now they are asking you, okay, write a question in the point slope form. And point slope, remember you need to have one point and one slope. Then you write an equation about the height. So it will be the height, and the height they tell you will be equal to the y in terms of the time in seconds, which will be the x, and the height will be in feet. This is important, which one is the y and which one is the x. If they don't tell you which one, then you decide, okay, this will be my y, this will be my x, and this time they are telling you. So y is height and x is time in feet, and height in feet, and time in seconds. So do I have a point here? Yes, the point I have is that after 2 seconds I am 25 feet above the boat, so my point will be, which is xy, x will be the time is 2 seconds, the y, the height is 25 feet. That's my point. For the point slope, I need a point and I need a slope. Do I have a slope? Slope, remember, is same than rate. Right here. Slope is the same as rate. M is equal to rate. The constant of proportionality. So my rate or my M is 10 feet per second. It's already in the same units, feet and seconds, so I don't need to convert. If I don't have the same units, I do need to convert. So now I have the point, 2125, and I have the slope. I can write now the formula. Y minus, my y here is 25, is equal to the slope times x minus x1 minus 2. Let me do this parenthesis. Y minus 25 is equal to 10x minus 20. And there you have your equation in a point slope form. If they ask you, okay, which height? Another question. Which height were you when you finished? At which height were you when they started pulling down you? J started pulling you down. Oh, another word is what I were you when you finished parasailing, right? You finished parasailing and they started to pulling you down. So just imagine this. I'm going to make a graph here. 4, 5, 6. I'm going to make in 5. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. 35, 40. And here, the x is the seconds, the y is the height, right, in feet. 1, 2, 3, 4 seconds. So let me plug the point that I do have. When there are 2 seconds, you are 25 feet about the boat. So they're starting, which was the height when they started pulling you down? So the height when they started pulling you down is when there were no seconds, right? So it will be sometime reaches this height when they hadn't started yet pulling you down, when you stop parasailing. So I know that what I need is that y-intercept. And to find a y-intercept, I can use that slope intercepted form because this number will be my y-intercept. So let me copy here the formula for the slope intercept, mx plus b. And I just need to solve for y, and I will have this form. So let me continue here. Y is equal to 10x minus 20. Oh, I made a mistake. They were pulling you down. It means that the slope is negative. This slope, because you are being pulled down, you are going in this direction. See, you are coming from above and going down. So this is a negative slope. So the rate over here needs to be minus 10. Need to be minus 10. Minus 10 times x is minus 10x. Minus and minus is 20. Minus 10x plus 20 plus 25 in the other side. I just had the signs here mixed up. So now let's see, minus 10x, 20 plus 25 is 45. My slope is the b, the number that is not with the x. The slope is the number with the x. This is my slope, 10, and this is my y-intercept. So I know that my y-intercept will be somewhere, is in here. The graph for this line, I'm going down. They're pulling me down. It's negative. These are my 2 points, the y-intercept. I was at 45 feet when I stopped parasailing or when they started pulling me down. If they ask you, if they give you 2 points and a slope, you can write it in point slope, and then you can solve for y. For y, to write it in a slope intercepted, if that's another question. I hope that helps. Have a good day.